cocktails from the strip.
No one has ever gone quicker. No one has ever gone faster than Kenny Bernstein.
Unbelievable.
300 miles an hour.
Can you believe it's been 25 years since that historic run at Gainesville Raceway?
You know, it's kind of funny, Lewis, thinking about that. I can't believe it on one side. You know, I go, it really does seem like yesterday. And then when I really stop and think about it, it is a long time ago.
Now let's take you back to the 1992 season. You know, not only you, but other teams were probably looking forward to that 300-mile-per-hour barrier-breaking run.
Everybody out there was at those days. Dale Armstrong, who was the crew chief of the Bud King at the time, he told everyone, whatever we do to this car, I want you to think about it going and breaking the 300 barrier. And he came to me and said, Kenny, it's really pretty simple. How much do you weigh now? And I don't know, I probably weighed 160 or something like that at the time. And he said, I need you to give me 10 pounds. When it left the starting line, I mean, it was up and gone. And it got to the finish line, and I popped the parachute out just like normal. I wasn't even thinking about 300. I see a bunch of people running around like crazy, and this guy's waving at me to come over here or whatever, and so I'm coasting in there. The guy gets in there and pounds me on the chest, the worker, and says, you just went three. And I thought he meant we qualified number three.
Sure.
And he says, no, you went
300 miles an hour. I can't believe
it. 301.
It's a dream come true, believe me.
Everybody was just screaming and hollering. And, I mean, it just caught everybody so off guard. I don't think anyone expected it at that time. And not only did it go 300, it went 301.
Yeah, you didn't just break into
it. Yeah, I mean, just didn't nudge it. I mean, it went on over the top.
Dale Armstrong was smart enough to kind of mark all the pieces of the race car. He knew how important that was, and now the car sits in the museum, and it's the exact car.
He took and marked every piston, every rod, the crankshaft, everything about it. He saved every piece of it. And one of the things that happened to me that really brought it to light was I owned a NASCAR team at the time. So on the off weekends that we weren't drag racing, I'd go to the NASCAR races. On that weekend after the 300, we were at a racetrack, and I started going up the stands, and the people just stood up and started clapping. Blew me away. NASCAR fans, they knew all about drag racing. It was unbelievable. Still is to this day.
Can I tell you, if there's one moment in NHRA history that I would have paid to have seen that I didn't, it might be that moment right there, Lewis.